Hello viewers, and welcome to the channel. Today we're going to be doing the first in the Kirby Cadet series. This is where we're going to start to draw it in DraftSight. So we'll get that open. I'm going to show you how to bring the image in. This is one I found off the net. Scale it to suit, and then we'll start tracing it. Let me show you the image first. If you do a Google Images search on Kirby Cadet, you'll find the... You'll find pictures of my cat. No, you won't find it. You'll find this one here. It's a tow line glider. I'm trying to zoom in. Use the slidinator. Right. Yeah, 30-inch span tow line glider. Now I'm going to scale it to 90. Make it radio control as opposed to free flight. Don't want it flying away. Although that would make for a good video. If it disappeared after the first flight. Yeah, so let's get going. What you also need to do is open this image in Paint, and you'll see why in a second. Do a Control A, which selects all the dotted edge around the edge of the picture. Control C for copy, then go into DraftSight, do a Control V. It's asking me for a position, 0, 0, and we're just plonk it down. Now that is in, and it's any old size, so we need to scale it. Now DraftSight does have an insert reference image function, but if you use that when you start trying to do your tracing, it will keep snapping to the corners or the middle of the picture, and it will just totally blow your mind. It's just not what you want at all. So there seems to be a bug in DraftSight, but copy and pasting it from another program like Paint, close Paint up, sorts that out. So here's our image. First thing I want to do is set myself up some layers. First one blue, green. I'll try and keep the video short, 15-20 minutes, 24 and asleep through them. So that's on layer 0, which is cool. To do the drawing, I'm going to draw on layer 1. That way you'll be able to see when I start tracing. You see the blue lines on top. Right, that looks okay. Yeah, I was going to change the crosshair because I thought it was white, but it's not, that's fine. Right, so let's scale this up. Like I said, we're going to make it 90 inches, so the first thing I'm going to need is a calculator. Although I work in inches, when I think about models, I draw them in millimetres. Right, old hotchpotch. So 90 inch times 25.4 gives me 2.286. And we're looking at half span on the plan, so we divide that by 2. 1143 is what we want. So, what I start off by doing is putting myself a line down through here, there somewhere, and then I'll come out, say, with the centre of that. No, I don't have the snap on for that, let's just check the settings, see what we're snapping to. Midpoint is now hot. Right, line center, and I'm going to come out until we get to the half span. Right, and now we're going to do the scale, because let's see what it is at the moment, just for reference. Inquiry, don't seem to have, excuse me, the inquiry toolbar on, so let's open that up. Inquiry toolbar, there it is. So at the moment, the drawing on our screen is 259.8 mil, and obviously that's about 10 inches, so it made the whole plane 20 inch span, so that's got smaller. So this is how you scale it. Now you could work out the scale factor by dividing the, you know, the 1143 by 259, and that'll give you the number to scale it up by. Or we use this scale function like this. Pick the image we want to scale. Let's actually just pick the whole lot. And it's telling me it's found three objects. It's asking me for a base point. I'll say 0, 0. I want it to scale around 0, 0. And next, it's asking me for the scale factor, but I don't know it, so I'm going to press right-click, reference. And what that allows me to do is pick a reference length on here, which is the half span. And now I can type in that 11:43 we just measured. So 11:43, press return, and it is now scaled the whole image to suit. And let's just verify that with the tape measure from there to there. If you look down below, 11:43. So that image is now our 90-inch span, which is perfect. Now the next thing I notice with this image, if I draw a line down the centre, as you can see, the drawing is slightly off. In the centre of the rudder, and there's the centre of the image. So again, I'm going to select all, my window in it, go for the rotate icon. Now I could do with rotating back a bit, so I'm going to pick nearest, so about there. And what I'm going to do again is go reference, so from one end of that line, so from where it is at the end of the rudder, and then click down onto that line. That has brought it down. If we delete that line because that moved with it, but let's now recheck. And with the thing horizontal, you can see the image now is nicely aligned down here. That one up there will have moved as well, so we'll stick him in again as well. Move that down. That's going to be in the front of the leading edge, and then let's make this X, that can be deleted as well because it's on an angle. Set up through. Across the page, so out to here, just tracing around the shape at the moment. Sorry about the background noise, I should have waited for everyone to go out before I attempted this, but and then down through here, so it's a, that's not a vertical line. I'm using the polar snap on this to try and pick vertical and horizontal. That should be vertical, which it is. Right, so let's trim those two. Do we trim those two back, or should we just stick a radius in? Right, and start by radius in that corner, which is the fillet command. Again, right click, radius. It's going to be about from there. There's the snap command. I'm not going to teach you how to use AutoCAD or DraftSight in this video. I'm just showing you, otherwise we'd be here forever, just showing you how I go about creating, you know, the geometry I need for a quick build like this. Let's put in the rear spar that can come across. Again, pick that one perpendicular to there. Make the rear spar 1/4 inch, 6mm perhaps. That sits in there somewhere. And then I'm going to copy that one. Am I, no, I'm not. Because it was looking for another offset. So pick, copy, and drag that down somewhere about there. plan as well somehow. I'm going to delete the second plan. Right, yeah. So there's my main spar, there's my rear spar. I've lined my rear spar up here. Actually looks a bit bear with. Yeah, perhaps we move the rear spar back a tad. So move so it's more around there. Where that and that meet there. I'm gonna move it to there. Right, so the reason I start off with a few layers is as I'm drawing, I can turn off layer 0 and see how it's looking. It's always handy to be able to do that. So, leading edge, half inch perhaps. Perhaps we have a 3/8 false leading edge and then the main 3/8 full leading edge and an 1/8 false leading edge. So, 10mm for the 3/8 is probably close enough. And then, what's an 1/8 of an inch in 3-point something, isn't it? 1 divided 8 times 25.4, 3.175, should have remembered that really. So 3.175, in that one goes. Again, I think we'll go for half inch wing tip. Gives us something to shape, so it's going to be 12.7. Sits in there. 12.7 sits there. We'll go for a 10. Do we have a 10mm trailing edge? Yeah, why not? 10mm. Yeah, looks pretty much like that. It's funny how it's sort of scaled pretty much as I'm to, you know, to what I'm thinking in my head as I go here. You get a feel for, you know, what looks about right. It's not set up the same as my other machine. So let's extend that. Let's sort this little mess out here. Alright, so what we're going to do is we'll turn the image off so I can get it out of the way. And then we'll select all that and go trim. So that can be trimmed into there. That can be trimmed back to there. I think that'd be okay. Again, extend that through. Again, I'm using the trim command. If you press shift, it acts as an extend command, which is quite cool. That then can be the trim. Trim that back. So that's beginning to look like a wing panel. So let's put this back on. So, rib spacing, they look all over the place, don't they? They don't look. A nice big one in the middle as well. Right, let's have a quick measure, see what they come in at. Approximately, we're looking at 85mm spacing on the plan, so perhaps we'll go do an array. Hey, where's my elements? So, what's that telling you? Pick center point, does it? There we go. Select an entity, we want that on there. And found. We want it to be a linear array. Vertical axis. Number vertically, just one. Number horizontally, we want 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. I can't see them all, so as luck would have it, let's cancel that. Let's move it along. Right, how many ribs is there? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. 14 copies, so let's go back, array, linear array, vertical copies 1, horizontal copies 14. That's the job I want. Some vertical spacing, we reckon was 85. And let's have a preview and see where that's going. You can see first one's not far out, and then we get miles out as we go up the wing. So if we press escape, we can change that, and let's drop that down to 82, see how it looks. Preview again, first one's pretty spot on, and then it goes way out as it goes up the wing. I think I'm going to come down again, so let's drop in at 78, preview, that looks pretty good. The aileron position is going to fall in alright. I need an extra one at the tip, so escape, going to make it 15, okay. Right, so that looks okay. Yeah, pretty happy with that as a starting point. Again, let's turn the image off. I'm going to pick that. I'm going to say trim, and then we'll go all of those lines there. Get rid of that. Do the same there, and then the same on the front of the wing as well. Trim all those back. And you can see, in no time at all, you know, we're starting to produce something here which is, you know, beginning to look like a wing panel. Not overly happy with the wing tip to last rib spacing, but it is what it is. You know, when you look at the ribs here, they don't look a million miles out. They are coming more out as they go further out. It looks to me like the rib spacing out to the where the wing strut sockets are is slightly different to the rib spacing beyond that. But that's okay, we'll live with that. That'll be fine. Right, well, next. I think next, we'll quickly sketch the rib and then call at the end of this video so far. I'm going to come off there to set the sizes. That's where my trailing edge is. Set this spar, projecting it up. Main spars are there. See that the views are not, well, I suppose they probably were drawn on top of each other. It's trouble with the scanned image, it loses a bit of its quality. Let's come down through there, down to about there somewhere, and then we'll whack a spline round the top. We'll start off the rib, and then we'll come on. Don't need a million points. Also, you probably notice this is a flat bottom section, which is great for the tow line glider. It won't be the most efficient airfoil we could have used for our model, but I'm really looking for something that's going to be simple for you guys to build as a first time, you know, build off a plan. Let's try and get around here. If we can build this flat on the board, you should have no problems building a nice straight wing with no twists, because the better you build the wing, the better your plane's going to fly. And then I need an intersection. That snap's not hot at the moment. It will be in a minute. Right, so now I'm going to pick that, and I'm going to adjust these in a tad. I'll try and smoothen out the look of that. Not liking that one. Let's bring him in. Looking a bit better. Let's perhaps we'll tweak him. That one's okay. That one needs to come out a little. And then that one there will need to come out. You can see I'm just playing with it until it looks about right. And that's the key for all aircraft builds. Just make it look right. Generally will be. Right, so that's okay. Again, let's turn off the image, trim that up. So, take those. And I do the same here. Trim, yeah, not happy with the shape through there at the moment. We'll have to do something about that. That can be deleted. It's also slightly more difficult where I'm looking at it on its side. You know, you get used to looking at airfoils from, you know, they're right way up, so to speak. So when I look at it like this, it's harder for me to tweak it so it looks right. But that's not a million miles away. I'll probably start there. Let's make these square. Let's turn the intersect snap on. So intersection, there we go. So we're looking at that one there. Probably have to move some of these in. So I'm going to have a bit of a skin round there. Lost me top spar. I think I'm also going to move the spars back. Looking at this, there's my maximum thickness. I'm going to straddle that with my spars. So let's pick them. Move. Let me pick the centre there. We go perpendicular to that line. And that moves it back. That's where I want my main spar. Rear spar's okay, it falls on the aileron position, that's fine. Let's put top spar in a second. I think I'm going to offset my sheeting next, 1.6mm. Put that in like so. Again, trim that back. It's looking okay. Actually, I've done that wrong. That's not looking okay. So if I undo. Trim. Let's leave an edge, we'll sit there. That's better. That's how that's going to sit. Spar needs to be on the sheeting. There'll be cap in between. Most of the wing will be open because I'm going to be able to get my aileron servos going to sit out here, and I'll be able to thread the cable through. With an open structure, that's going to be a lot easier. Again, I don't want to build it into the wing if this is going to be your first build. So I don't want to make it too complicated. Let's put that where it needs to be. Somewhere there, circle there, line. Someone's turned the tap on. Unfortunately, that's going to make a lot of noise for a few minutes. Right, so let's have a look. Yeah, it's not looking too bad now. Something's not right there. Let's trim that over there. Let's turn the image back on. This is obviously going to be semi-scale. I don't know how scale this image was to start with, the tow line glider. But anyway, you can see I made a few adjustments. I want the main spar on rip max fitness, so move that back. The aileron's going to be in there. Yeah, that'll probably be okay for that at the moment. I'm going to do some changes to that later. Yeah, I think that's probably going to do for this part of the video. And anyway, yeah, catch me next time. See you soon.